go with McGuire. They go.
Boston Bruins Alumni TV, John Horrigan, joined by Bruins great Jay Miller. Jake, thanks for coming on.
John, thank you. It's a pleasure always, Bruins Alumni.
Jay, Natick, Massachusetts, you grew up out of UNH. You got a chance to play with a hometown team. Did you ever expect that while you were playing?
No, not in one day. Never took it for granted. When they called me up, I pinched myself every day. I still pinch myself to this day when people ask me, you know, how was it? I said, you can't put explain it into words. You know, going on that ice in the old Boston Garden was something that I will never forget. And then playing, you know, 4.5 years, 280 games in the Garden, breaking some records. It was a lot of fun. And having your family, my dad, my mom, my brothers, and my wife, and my children never saw me. But that's the only thing I do regret. I just had a grandchild, and they named him, you know, Weston J, and I'm really proud of that. So there is something to fall back on. You know, when I get stopped in the street, it's funny that I still get a chill. I still go, boy, they remember me. So that's something that you'll never forget from the old Boston Garden and being a Bruin. Because once you know, one game as a Bruin, you're always a Bruins alumni. They can never take that away from me, my family, or anybody else. So that's the proudest part of my, other than my kids. But yeah, being a Bruin alumni.
And you filled a role when you joined the team, obviously, when you came out. They weren't going to take a run at any of your skilled players. You were, I would say, a regulator because you guarded the team.
Let's call it this. I was a goon, enforcer, you know, pugilist, whatever the case. I wouldn't call it that. So, yes, game has changed. But go on with the question. Thank you for being so politically correct.
Sure. So, okay. So, the pugilist, the goon, went on to set a Bruins single-season mark for the most penalty minutes in one season. But some of
without a major.
Without a major.
Yeah,
sure.
Without
yep. Well, you know, you were disappointed.
Five-minute major without a 10-minute misconduct.
Yeah, right. And you ranked 1,555 in the Lady Bing Award balloting every single season.
But is that just, how many players there was in the league?
I believe so, in the 88. So now talk about, though, some of your battles are still on YouTube, epic battles. Obviously, the late John Kordick. Chris Nyland every single night. You had Bob Probert.
Well, it's funny, somebody, Luke Robitaille and Gretzky were talking about it. A couple months ago, we were in Chicago, Denny Savard's tournament. And I never really realized this because goal scorers get the night off. Checkers get the night off. Goaltenders get the night off. Fighters, goons, pugilists, enforcers, they very rarely ever got a night off. You always had to be on your game. Very rarely to have somebody across the ice that was not gunning for you or wanted to take a cheap shot at one of your players because, and I'm not saying that in a bad or a light, but if you look back at the old time hockey and the way it was, and I didn't look at it this way, but now that I'm older in my age and I'm looking back at it saying, geez, it really was. I played an 80 game schedule and I don't think I ever went into a rink or in the Garden and said, oh, I could sit at the end of the bench and just watch the game. Never happened.
So some guy trying to make his mark.
Always. Every training camp, I don't blame him. I had these kids from Saskatchewan, from Ontario, from New Brunswick, from Vancouver. Kids, farm boys that come up and they want to make a name for themselves. And I didn't mind it. I never took it for granted. But my biggest asset in my arsenal was my fear. I hate to lose. And at my business now and when I played, because I had 19 guys that I had to look down the bench and look at me and say, you know, if you lose one battle, they kind of get down. So you never want them down. So that's why I was always up for my game and always up for what I did. And I respect that, what I did. I have no problems saying I was a goon or a tough guy. What I do now in my life, I have no problem saying it.
I want to talk about that with the Courtyard Restaurant, one of the finest restaurants on the Cape, if not the best. You've been a longtime supporter of the Boston Bruins alumni and the various charities and the games that you play in, but also for the golf tournament. So that's always a great place, and I have just fond memories of being there. And obviously, I'm trying to butter you up next time I come down, maybe get a free draft.
You'll get a free draft. I'll give you a free dinner. But yeah, the Bruins alumni, I talked to Rick Middleton, Ray Bork, and Cam, and I said, guys, we never really get together by ourselves. And I mean by no hanger-on, there's nothing wrong with hanger-on. No, you know, I'm talking trainers and the guys to tell stories. No wives, no girlfriends, no kids, no sons. I'm talking the games. See, if you ask Ray and Cam who were the best team they played for, and I bet everyone will say the 88 team when we beat Montreal. And I try to get all the guys that played one game or not for the Boston Bruins, all alumni. We try to get them back to my restaurant. I bring them down to my club to play golf. And I really look forward to that every year because it gets all the guys together back and telling locker room stories. Because the game we can go away from, we can miss, but the locker room you can never take away from us.
And finally, we didn't talk about this, but you did mention Gretzky going to the glitter of going from the Boston Garden to the glitter of the Los Angeles Kings. Luke Robitaille, Wayne Gretzky, all those Hall of Famers that skated the
nine
team.
Yeah.
Wow, nine Hall of Famers. What was that experience like? And you still talk with those guys today, don't you?
I still stay close with all of them. We're all still good friends. That 90 team we had was a pretty good team, and we stay close together. And it's funny because I like to say that I'm friends with all of them. I've never really gone back and said what team's better than the other, because to me, just being around the guys and being 19 guys, no matter who they were, that was a lot of fun for me. And I love protecting them all, especially G-Man. You know, he's been wonderful to me and my family. Luke and Rob Blake and Larry Robinson and Yuri Curry and Paul Coffey go down the list, and they just, we've all been good friends. I've been fortunate enough to be friends with them. Everybody looks up to them like they're big shots. They still bleed, they still put their pants on the same way, and they're extraordinary gentlemen that I respect for the rest of my life, and they respect me and I respect them. So that's why we all get along, and I haven't met a bad hockey player yet.
Nor have I. John Horrigan, joined by Jay Miller. Thanks, Jay.
Thank you, John. Thank you for Boston Bruins Alumni.